It's just a little after 3:30, so we'll call this a special meeting to order. We have one item to discuss, and that, or did you want to take roll first?
I've got it.
Okay. We have one item to discuss, and that is to consider awarding the bid for the East Business Loop Reconstruction Project. And you have copies of everything. We have the engineers on the project with us if you have any questions about anything. You need to explain anything, really. This is everything we expected it to be, and
And more,
lucky us. And correct me if I'm wrong, but because there's so much Department of Transportation funds involved in this project, if we wanted to change anything in awarding this bid, it would be cumbersome, so to speak.
Yeah, in a nutshell, if there are minor elements, including the parking lane, like you've decided to eliminate, it's better to handle it on a change order basis at this point rather than try to handle it before the contract signing.
Okay. I think that clarifies it. Anything else?
Mayor, just a reminder of where this bid falls within the engineer's estimates.
Well, the DOT enforced estimate, it was just a little bit under 10%. The actual engineer's estimate before the DOT force was a little under 6%.
Increase over the engineer?
Yep.
Okay. Because some elements came in above and some came in.
Right. And what's amusing is that from a balance standpoint, it actually is quite beneficial to the city because of the way it came in and as far as the special assessments are concerned.
Okay. Good.
Good.
Other questions?
Move to approve the awarding of the bid to Sellen Brothers Incorporated of Holly, Minnesota in the amount of $5,347,860.90.
It's been moved by Councilmember Schultz. Is there a second?
I'll second.
It's been seconded by Councilmember Gumke. Any further discussion? Further discussion? Okay. Let me call the roll.
Mayor Anderson?
Aye.
Councilmember Gumke?
Aye.
Schultz?
Aye.
Nygaard?
Aye.
The motion carries. Is there any other business before this special meeting?
I just have a question of Alte. I've had a couple of people or property owners down there that have just contacted me within the last couple of weeks. I don't know if Sellen has started moving some equipment to town or what, but they're asking questions about how the detours are going to be handled and access to properties and that type thing. I've had two of them, in fact, and one on Friday and one today. Do you know when, are you going to have a meeting with those people to go through all that? Do you know what the schedule might be for that or about when you might be looking at that so I can just give them an idea that, you know, about such and such a time they can expect to hear something?
Yeah, Mayor and Council and Jeff, we have a pre-construction conference, thank you, April 11th. His memory is so much better than mine. That's why I write everything down. April 11th, where we'll, you know, sit with the contractor. One of the things the contractor is required to have is a public relations person that will go door to door to discuss issues with the business owners. So we don't have their contractor schedule yet as to when they're actually going to start. They do have two backhoes sitting on the end of the off the parking lot at the truck stop right by the entry sign, the plantings right off the end of the truck stop. So they're starting to move equipment in. And so, yes, people start to get nervous that we're going to start soon. But before we get started, after the April 11th meeting when we sit down and talk with their public relations person, Clint and I and their PR person will start to go around and talk to them about access. It's the same as we've discussed all along the corridor since we started the project on how they're going to get there. There'll be 24/7 access to every business on the opposite side of construction with temporary roadways. There will be signing that we'll be able to put up that was part of the project that was bid that says, for instance, Don's Garden right. Center with an arrow directing them across on this temporary driveway. So we're going to do everything we can to make sure that access to business, though will be a little bit with construction, they'll still have access during construction. I mean, if the driveway moves over here, it's going to be over here, but they'll still have access to the businesses.
I also specifically had a question about the road, that goes out to where Farmers Union is and then out to the state hospital, if that road is going to be impacted or access to that road. So do you know which one I'm talking about?
Yes, this is where Councilman Schultz goes to work every day and comes home.
All right.
So, yes.
So I have a question about that too, yeah. No, we did discuss that earlier.
Yes. Our traffic control section, the plans are about that thick. Traffic control is about that thick because it's of the detailed nature. I think we have four or five sub-traffic control layouts just for that intersection because we're going to be shifting traffic back and forth as things progress through. Again, there may be times when they're actually working in the area that they'll have one lane of traffic with flaggers, but at the end of the night, they'll open it up to two-way traffic so that it's always going to be open.
Okay. Well, and I knew you had the parts of your plan. I just kind of maybe want to know what type of response to give the public when they ask, not specifically the business owners, but of how they may want to, how much notice they need for how to change their travel routes, if
they
need
to. Can I try this?
Okay.
The premise of the plans, Mayor, was to keep traffic open throughout the course of the project, even on what amounts to the main direction, which is the main line, so to speak. The emphasis on this is that as long as the traveling public is willing to live with a little slower of a pace through that area, they can continue to use that corridor every direction they're using it now.
Okay.
They simply have to acknowledge there's going to be construction, there's going to be equipment, men and machines, women and machines out there working, and they need to be cognizant of that, slow down, and accept that there'll be a few minutes delays here and there.
Okay.
But otherwise, the whole corridor will remain open during construction.
Okay. I think that will help answer some of the questions. You get just the generic ones, not specific to each business.
Well, I don't know if you've gotten any from the truck stop yet, and we've worked with Mr. Reitinger quite a bit on laying out the traffic control through there. But the frontage road that where the semis are parked and some of the vehicles along the southerly edge of his lot is a frontage road that we'll be using for the detour, if you will. We'll have cones and barrels, but we'll still have access to the pumps at controlled locations so people aren't driving all over. The truck stop cafe will still be open, you know, full access to that business as well.
All right. Any other questions? Any other business before we adjourn? Okay. Then the motion to adjourn would be in order.
So moved.
It's been moved by Councilmember Gumke. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Councilmember Schultz. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? We're adjourned.